Only on 5 tonight, cowardly crooks attacking people who can't defend themselves. Now, these criminals are robbing the disabled and the elderly. I know, it's pretty sick. And News 5's Stephanie Stone is live tonight with the exclusive details for you. Stephanie?
Even detectives say it's unusual. The same group of people targeting those who can't fight back. And what's even more outrageous, a lot of these suspects are only getting away with a few bucks.
I turned and asked him, I said, what do you want? And and I turned my chair so it made him off balance and he hit me in my chest.
It was a normal trip to the store up the street from her Roselawn assisted living community. Joanne put change in her pocket, then noticed someone following her. She's still scared of her attacker and asked us not to show her face. And she's angry that some think she's weak.
It makes me feel like I'm not the person that I am, because I'm not an easy target. But then I'm also not a strong person. I'm in this wheelchair for a reason.
She's not alone. The detectives at District 4 have a pile of cases just like Joanne's.
Usually they assault the victims right away by punching him in the face, knocking him to the ground, and taking their property.
In Joanne's case, she only had change, so the culprit didn't get away with anything. Police say that's not unusual, but what is unusual is the people behind the crime.
It's unusual to have a what we believe is related crimes going on.
McKinney says they're teens or young adults between 15 and 21. They work in groups of 2 and 3, looking for people who they believe are easy targets. But if you ask Joanne, she now carries a cell phone and stun gun and even has a plan should she be attacked again.
I'll find ways to take care of myself. I'll run over. This is what I say.
And tonight, police have some pretty good leads. They've notified assisted living communities. They're looking at surveillance video. And in the meantime, they ask that people stay in well-lit areas and travel in groups. We're live tonight. Stephanie Stone, News 5.